My favorite part of Toastmasters. Today, Anand Moore will be giving his third speech. This speech is part of his Competent Communicator, Project Number 3, Get to the Point. With this speech, his aim is taking you on an exciting journey by giving fun facts about car travel in India. And after seeing Eat, Pray, Love, I cannot wait to hear about car travel in India. The name of his speech is Oh, What Fun It Is to Ride. Please welcome Anand Moore to the stage.
Oh, what fun is to ride the
one horse open sleigh.
Well, this morning, when you got out of the home and walking towards the car, coming to office, did you feel proud because you own the car? Or was that car driving when you feel excited because you're going to drive this car now? Or was that fun? And you felt like jingling like the way I did it. Well, fellow Toastmasters, guest, every car ride in India is fun, adventure, excitement, and you feel like jingling every time. Well, there are three reasons why car ride is fun, exciting, adventure, whatever you call it. First reason is, car driving in India is very cheap, which is not here. This is the cheapest car in India. Any guess how much it must be costing?
$2,500.
Pretty close. It cost $2,100 on the road. It's not just cheapest, but it runs. Well, it runs pretty cheap. What it means, it gives the mileage of 50 to 60 miles per gallon.
Wow.
And it's not a hybrid or electric car. It's just a natural, normal gas car. So, buying a car is not a big deal in India. And driving is the more cheapest fact, fun fact to have. Well, how about safety? I mean, that's the next question comes after the cost. Well, it's very safe. I mean, what kind of safety you will need when you drive 25 miles per hour in Indian roads?
Oh my God.
That's pretty much safe. That's the first reason. So pretty much there are a lot of cars, not just one car which is in same segment or same mileage segment which I told you. There are a lot of choices you will have to drive the car. But that's not the only reason you should have felt proud about the car which you own. Car in India is pretty much a status symbol. It doesn't matter what kind of car you own. It doesn't matter size, brand, or you know, the luxury. Or even if it's a junkest car which is available on the road, you drive that one and you should feel proud about it. Because when you're driving that junk car, everybody will give you the road. Even animals and the creatures, whatever available on the road. So you feel pretty much proud about having that junk car with you. If you have imported cars, something like Ford Focus or Hyundai Accent, you're pretty much a big rich person. That means you own the business or you either are the manager in the good company. And if you have car something like this, this is a white ambassador back in 1930s, it invented and it has the same kind of machine right now. That means you are sitting politician. Either you are in Congress or you are elected in your area. So everybody owes the respect to this car. So it's a status symbol. Well, there is another reason, which is the third and my most favorite reason to think car drive as a more fun. Because it's most hassle-free. I mean, here you want to drive a car You need to have the driver's license, insurance. You need to get your safety done. You should have wipers. You should have tires to drive the car.
Tires would help, yeah.
But in India, those formalities are not much required. Pretty much everything which runs, you can drive, and without any so-called documentation required. Just make sure that you have 1,000 rupees, which means this $20 bill in your pocket, and you're ready to go. Now, somebody thinks, you know, like me, I want a license. Then no problem. You will get the license at home. You need not to go for driver's exam or need not to give that, you know, driving test with the that parallel parking or whatever you call it. So pretty much driving is very safe there. Now, how about the rules and regulations? If I don't give the driver's exam or if I haven't read that big manual, don't worry. Aren't there are no much of rules or regulations in Indian roads anyway. You can pretty much drive any direction you want. You can stop anywhere you want. You can park anywhere you want. I'm not joking. Well, it's not that there are no rules or regulations. There are few rules and regulations. One basic rule is that don't hit anybody. Obvious, right? There is another rule, right of way, which is pretty much easier actually. Right of way here is pretty much you need to do recitals of who should go first and who should not go first. That is a very simple rule. The bigger the size, you will get the right of way. Which means you are in car, then all small animals, all small animals and all small animals like a dog, a cat, monkeys, pigs, everybody will give you the right of way. And since you are in car, the bigger things like a truck or bus or maybe camels or elephants, you should give the right of way to them because those are bigger than you. And trucks, buses, camel, elephants will give right of way to trains.
Whoa.
So it's pretty much easier. Another easy fact. If you have a small car and you got a big family, you need not to buy a big minivan or SUV to fit that family. Or if you got the guest in home. There are no rules and regulations how many people can sit in one small car. You can pretty much have 8, 9, 10 people sitting in one small sedan. As much as the extra person is comfortable sitting on other's lap or maybe in the trunk. Can you count how many folks are here? Don't miss this fellow, he's not a driver. And there is a driver inside here somewhere.
Oh my God.
Well, for kids it's more fun because they need not to worry about car seat and those comfortable beds or the booster seats. They can sit pretty much anywhere, back seat, front seat, driver seat or tub or maybe in the trunk. Wherever those are sitting, they should always be singing. Oh, what fun is to ride the car in India.